गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन। हेलो
हेलो अर्जुन, एम आई ऑडिबल?
यस पवन।
ऑल राइट, आई विल लाइव नाउ।
यस ओके। यस
आर वी लाइव, यस और नो?
वी आर इन लाइव।
ऑल राइट, गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स हु हैव जॉइंड टुडे सेशन। एंड टुडे आल्सो वी आर गोइंग टू कवर द अनदर टॉपिक इन टैबलू, सो वी विल ट्राई टू ग्रैब समथिंग न्यू। So Skill Up Right team, welcome all of you. So let's wait for the couple of more minutes so that other participant can join for today's session and we can kick off the session at 12:35. Arjun, could you please go on mute?
Yeah, Pawan.
Yeah, Shreya, session, we are going to start the session. First of all, confirm onto the chat section, is my screen properly visible and am I audible properly? Then we can start the session. Am I audible properly, guys? And my screen is visible properly? All right. So yes, let's start the session for the day. Today, yesterday, we are supposed to cover maps and scatterplot, but we only had 1 hour. So what we have done is we have covered the basic filters, how we can use the basic filters in Tableau. And I gave you the concept of global filter also, that how you can apply a global filter in Tableau. Today, we are going to cover the maps and scatterplot, that how we can create our maps and scatterplot. And I will also give you one of the more usable filter also as a practical example. I'm not going to cover anything as of theory. I will be just giving you the proper practical example. So in next 1 hour, be serious, be focused. You will be learning something. Okay. I won't waste your time, and not even yours and not even mine. I don't believe in theories. If you have any doubt, any query, you can ask me in the chat section. Once that example is finished, once I will complete that particular example, then only I'll be able to answer all of your queries. And yes, a lot of people were asking about the recordings. So I hope you got the recording for yesterday's session. And if you want the recording for today's session as well, what you need to do is you just need to go to this link. This is the link where you can go. You can click onto this link. This is our website's link. This is www.skillupride.com, where you can get all the previous recording as well as the recording for yesterday's session and as well as the recording for today's session as well. If you are watching our recording onto Facebook, kindly like our Facebook page and follow our Facebook page so that you can get the upcoming notifications. And as well as if you're watching the video onto YouTube, subscribe to our channel as well. All right. So yes, let us start the session and don't waste the time, because time is more important than money. All right, so this is the first basic user interface of Tableau. Once you open the Tableau software, and before creating the data visualization, I will give you a brief about the source file, what source file we have with us, and then so that you will be having a basic understanding of the source file, that what is the source file, and first try to understand the data, and then only you will be able to do something, right? The source file name is Maps, Scatterplot, and Dashboard. These are the all source file for the respective module. For each and every 20 module, we have a respective source file, which we'll be giving you for the advanced course so that you can do, you can have your own practice. You don't have to worry about the source file for each and every module. For each and every module, we have a separate example, a separate case study, a project kind of case study, a project requirement, and we will be fulfilling those project requirement while applying these concept of Tableau. These are the different concepts of Tableau, that is groups and set, LOD, creating animation, ranking, dashboard, RDBMS concept, joins and all. So for every module, we have a separate source file, so you don't have to worry about the source file as well. And this is the data what we have is, Now let me zoom in the file and let me show you that what data we have with this source file. We are going to work on this file, right? This is the order date. This is the customer name. This is the city. This is the country. This is the region. And this is the segment. And this is the shipping, right? So while seeing this data, the basic understanding what we are getting is that this data is related to some e-commerce website. First, let me start the recording so that we can give you the recording as well. All right, the recording of the session has been started. I was talking about the source file. While seeing the data on the source file, it seems that the data is related to any e-commerce website data where customers are placing some order, and this is the order ID, this is the order date, this is the customer name, this is the city where they are ordering some data, some products, this is the country, this is the region. But we don't have measures, we have dimensions over here, right? Now we also have two more tabs. This is the list of order tab, and this is the orders breakdown tab. This is the second tab what we have in this Excel file. Now let me just zoom in the data so that you can see it quite clearly. This is the data we have. This is order ID again, and this is the product name. And in this particular tab, we have measures, we have numbers on which we will be going to, or we are going to perform any mathematical calculation, right? Sales, profit, discount. So yes, these are the measures what we have with us, right? Now list of orders and order breakdown, these are the two tabs which we have, and we are going to use both of the tabs. But there is one thing which is common between both the tabs, is order ID. But there is one more important thing to keep in mind before creating your data visualization. In this particular sheet, this is the list of order. And in this list of order, these order IDs are unique. Okay. In this list of order, these order IDs are unique. We do not have any duplicate values as far as this order IDs are concerned. But in this tab, the order breakdown, we have a duplicate order IDs. 397, 397, 397. Can you see that? Why do we have a duplicate order ID? Because here the tab name is orders breakdown. It is a quite a practical scenario. In one order, you can place multiple, you can place your multiple items, right? Multiple items you can place. Like on a single order, let's suppose you have done a purchasing in your lockdown period from an Amazon website. And in a single order, you have purchased a laptop as well as you have purchased a mouse as well as you have purchased a laptop bag as well. So in the similar order ID, you can purchase three items, and that's a practical scenario. Now we have to keep this mind, or we have to keep this factor in consideration before creating our data visualization. I hope the source file is quite clear to you. Now let's move on to create our data visualization directly on Tableau itself. So I hope the source data is quite clear. Let me connect that Excel file. Click on to that Excel file. And let me go to the module 11, that is maps, scatter plots, and dashboard. All right, all the three tabs we have with us. Can you see that? All the three tabs we have with us, that is list of order plus order breakdown plus sales target. Sales target we will not be using for our data visualization purpose. We will be using only these two tabs. The Excel file is same. In the same Excel file, we have two tabs, list of order plus order breakdown. Now we will be using a join, a RDBMS concept. So don't worry if you are not aware about the RDBMS concept. I'll give you a basic brief about the join, that how Tableau will perform a join between these two tabs. And still, if you want to learn more about the RDBMS concept and all the joins, that will be covered in our advanced topic. That will be covered in our advanced training, right? So for now, to create the data visualization, what I need to do is I can drag and drop this list of orders here. See, I have all the data with me. all the data, whichever was there in my Excel file, I have all the data with me for list of order. Let me double click over here. All right. Now I'm going to perform a join. I'm going to perform a RDBMS join. Now what I need to do is I just need to drag and drop orders breakdown and let me put it over here. And you are done. You have done a join. Now, how do you know which type of join is happening? How do you know on which column joining is happening? So for that, you don't have to do anything. You just have to click onto this button, this area, and you can see it is doing a inner join. Tableau has a variety of joins: inner join, left outer join, right outer join, and full outer join. So can you see that in the inner join? In the inner join, a gray color is there and it is written as inner join. That means we are doing an inner join. If you want to do a left outer join, you can just click over it and left outer join will be happening. If you want to do a right outer join, just click on to right outer join and right outer join will be happening. And finally, if you want to go with a full outer join, click on to full outer join and a full outer join will be happening, right? And on the column on which the join is happening, that is order ID. Order ID is equals to order ID. This is the common column which is available in both the sheets on which joining is happening. Right now we are going with the inner join. Now, what is the concept of inner join says? The concept of inner join says that all the common values between both the tables, or all the common values between both the sheets, right? So here, as I told you, that 397, there are a lot of order IDs which were duplicated. So this is the concept of inner join, that all the common values between both the tabs. But there is one more concept in inner join or in join, that let's suppose if you have a duplicate row, if you have a duplicate row in the second sheet, so first row, the first sheet will also be duplicated just to match up the rows, just to match up the rows. Can you see here 397, 397 are the duplicate rows? So just to match up this 397, 397, 397, this entire three rows are duplicated just to match up the second sheet. Again, if you want to check for 714, see here 714 is duplicated from the second sheet. And just to match up these two rows, the 714 from the first tab has been duplicated. The entire row has been duplicated just to match up the rows, right? So this is the concept of inner join. This is the concept of RDBMS inner join, right? Now, my data is good to go. I have created a join between both the tabs. Now I can create my data visualization. Okay. Now go to sheet one. I hope that you are quite aware or you are quite familiar with this user interface, because I've been talking about this user interface quite a lot of time. All right. Here you can see this is my dimension section, and here you can see this is my measure section. And you can also have a clarity that this data, this particular dimension is coming from the list of orders, and this particular dimension is coming from the order breakdown, right? This particular dimension is coming from list of orders, and this particular dimension is coming from the order breakdown, right? Now, if I don't like this view, I want everything to be combined as a single dimension, then what I need to do is, I just need to click here, right click over here, and I just need to click on this option called group by folder. So everything will be together. All the families will be together in lockdown period, right? So this is the complete dimension set, and this is the complete measure set. And let me mind you, this is coming from both the tabs, right? And this is also. Now my data is available. I have just imported my data into my Tableau. My dimensions are ready. My measures are ready. Now what I need to do is I just need to create a data visualization. But to create a data visualization, your requirement should be very much clear. Your requirement should be very much clear. Clarity has a more power. The more clarity you have, the more you will be successful in life. The less the clarity is, and then everything is gone. So what we are going to make, what is the purpose? So we are learning it on the basis of some practical requirement, some practical business challenge, some project requirement, All right. Now, what is the project requirement? The project requirement is that the business is telling us that we need to create or we need to calculate the profit margin. Okay, they have a data for the some e-commerce website. So they are saying that we have to calculate the profit margin for every single state. We have to create the profit margin for every single state. When I say state, here is a column for state. That means we have to work with some map. We have to work with some geographical column, right? So we are going to see that how we can create a profit margin for every single state. So let us see that how we can build that requirement or how we can fulfill that business requirement. Now let me just click on to this particular we have a country column, so let me just drag and drop this country column over here. Whatever countries are there in my source data, all the countries will be available as a map in my work area. All right, and here you can see a country pill has been created in the marks card. All right, a country pill has been created. Now if I want to go with a state wise, I just need to click onto this plus button. And I will be getting this state. Right? Now, if I want to create my data visualization on the basis of city, I can create it on the basis of city. Okay, you can click onto this plus button and you can go city wise. But right now, this is not my requirement. My requirement is only that I want to calculate the profit margin for every single state. So let me be at the state level. I will not be going to the city level. All right. So this is how you can go with a state level. Now you can see in the column and row shelf, some longitude and latitude has been created automatically. What is that longitude and latitude? If you are creating with some map, if you're working with some map, or if you're working with some geographical location, this longitude and latitude will be created automatically. The longitude and latitude, the meaning of longitude and latitude is, this is the line which is connecting your South Pole to North Pole in your globe. All right. So you don't have to be worried about it. Tableau will take care of it. You just have to play with your map. All right. Now, one more important thing to keep your data visualization in your mind, that if anyone else is doing a data visualization, they won't be doing a data visualization on the basis of some, for every year. Any business does a data visualization year wise. What is the calculation for 2012? What is the calculation for 2013? What is the calculation for 2014? In that way, year wise, they will go. Okay, so we have to also go in a similar way. We cannot have a data visualization for all the years, right? So for that, what I need to do is I just need to drag and drop order date. We have a date column. Yes, we do have a date column, order date. This is my data visualization order. This is my column, order date. I have to leverage of this particular, I have to take the benefit of this column. So what I'll do it, I'll take this column, order date, and put it into filter shelf. Okay. And I'll click on years. I'll click on years and I'll click on next. It is asking me that this many of year are available in your data sheet. What to do now? Check everything. 2011, 2012, 13 and 14, and click on apply and click on OK. I have a order date, year of order date column is available in my filter shelf, right? Now what I can do is I can click over here and I can click on show filter. Okay, I can click on show filter. right? And I can just click on 2011 so that I'll be getting the data for 2011 only, right? But this is a multi-value checkbox. I don't like this. I want to check only a single value at a time. So what I need to do is I just need to click over here and I just need to check this option called single value list. Let me repeat that point. I want to convert that multiple checkbox into a single value list. What I need to do is I just need to click over here and I just need to click on single value list. Okay. Now that multiple checkbox have been converted into a single value list. Let me click on 2012 if I want to analyze the data for 2012 only. All right. Now, what else we have to do? So, as I told you that we have to calculate the profit margin for every single state. So first of all, we have to see what columns we have. We have sales. Okay. So what we can do is just to get a start or just to get a feel, what we can do is we can take the sales and we can put it into size box. Why I am putting that sales into a size box? What is the reason for that? I am taking that sales and I'm putting into the size because I wanted to see in the map that a circle should be created according to the size of the sales. The more the sales will be, the more the size of the circle will be. The less the sales will be, the less the size of the circle will be. Let us try that. Let me take that sales and let me put into size. Okay, some circles have been created. Some small circles, some bigger circles. The size of the circles is telling me that if the circle is bigger, then the sales is bigger. You can see this circle, this size legend has been created. It is giving you the minimum value and the maximum value as well, right? If you want to increase the size, because we have a lot smaller circle, we can go to this size and we can increase the size. Somewhat we can increase the size so that at least we can see them. All right. So yes, that is enough. Now, if you hover your mouse cursor onto any particular circle, what is the information you are getting in your tooltip? This is the following information we are getting into our tooltip. The country is United Kingdom, the state is England, and the sales that we have done for this England region is 94,734. Okay, we have a couple of bigger and smaller circles. Let me go to this circle or let me go to this circle or any other circle. Or let us go with some other country. Okay. We have a country called Denmark and here is the name of the state and this is the sales which we have done, 725, right? Now, what else we can do to improve our data visualization or to achieve the end result, right? What we can do is we can go to the color box and we can give them a border so that it will be, you know, giving us, and we can also highlight the border. So again, go to the color box and at last there is an option called hello and let me click on to here. So yes, they are now properly visible, right? But we are now good to go. We are able to see the sales, but this was not our requirement. We have states with us, but we wanted to see the profit margin for every single state. How much the profit margin we have, since we are a business company. So of course we want to calculate our profit margin, right? So to calculate the profit margin, we have to create a calculated field. Now let me introduce a concept in Tableau, which is called a calculated field. All right. What is the calculated field? As far as your calculated field is concerned, this calculated field, which is not available in your data sheet, you are going to calculate or you are going to create that calculated field to use that field into your data visualization, right? And this is a manually created field. How do I create a calculated field? Right click over here and click on this option called create calculated field. Right click over here and this is the option create calculated field. All right. And this is the window which will be coming. Now let me give a name to that field. What should be the name? Profit margin. And let me press a tab key. Now let me show you one more thing. Whatever formulas and function you have available in your Excel file, all those formulas and functions are available in Tableau as well. You just need to click onto this arrow button and you can see all the formulas and function. Whatever you want to use in your calculation, you can use these formulas and function in your calculation, right? Now we are not going to cover all each and every formulas and function. This needs to be covered in the advanced course. But right now for our understanding, we will be using a formula called sum. Sum formula is available in Excel as well, right? Now to calculate the profit margin, I just need to perform a basic mathematics. I need to divide my sum of profit by my sum of sales. So let me write the formula over here. Sum, press a tab key and let me give as profit and let me divide the sum of profit from the sum of sales. Sales we do have. That is why it is giving you the suggestion that sales. Just press a tab key and this will take it automatically. And can you see the message? The calculation is valid. You should be getting this message. That means my calculation is valid. Let me click on apply. Let me click on OK. I have a field created that is known as profit margin. Now, how can I identify? How can I identify that this has been, that this is the field which has been calculated by me? Can you see the equals to sign? Can you see this equals to sign? This equals to sign signifies that this is a calculated field which has been created by a user. This was not the available field in the source data sheet, right? Now, yes, this field has been created. What I can do is I can drag and drop this field into my data visualization. Let me take that field and let me put it into color box. I have a color box. Let me put it into color box. Now, these circles, are giving some shade of colors. And this color legend has also been created. What is the meaning of these colors? If the color is blue, you can see this color legend. If the color is blue, that means it's a positive profit margin. Can you see that? I hover my mouse cursor onto this particular state. The profit margin is 0.216. The profit margin is 0.216. Now let me hover my mouse cursor onto some orange color dot. This is the country name. This is Netherlands. This is the state name. This is the sales that we have done, 2,210. And the profit margin is minus 0.644, which is very, very bad. Companies are not worried about this orange, this blue circles. Companies are, or the management or the CEO of the company, there's the orange dots which are giving them the nightmares. Now they have to do something to solve this problem. Whether they have to deploy a marketing people over there, whether they have to investment, they have to do some investment into the marketing, or they have to do something so that they can get rid of this negative profit. Negative profit margin. And this is how you present your data in front of your management people so that they can take some management decisions. No one can take the decisions without any intelligence, and you are giving them some intelligence. What is the job of CBI? The job of CBI is to give the intelligence to the authority, to the management of government, to the government of India. So according to their inputs, the government of India can take the decisions according to their intelligence, which has been given by the agencies. So here you are giving some intelligence to the management people. This is the situation for each and every state. Now you take whatever situation or whatever decision you want to take, whether you want to shut down your business, whether you want to continue with your business, whether you want to improve your business. Now it's in your hand. And this is the job of a Tableau developer. All right. Now we have calculated the profit margin for every single state, but we can do one more thing. We can just adjust this color shade. Now, how do I adjust this color shade? To adjust the color shade, this has nothing to do with profit margin. Profit margin will be same, but I just want to play with the color shades of the circles. How do I play with the color shades? Here you click over here and click on edit colors. let me repeat that point. You click over here and let me click on edit color. This particular window will be opening, right? Now click on advance. Here you give the starting value as 0.5. So this will give me the color sheet. Okay, the starting value will be 0.5 and the ending value will be 0.415. It is around 0.5, so that is okay for me. Starting value starting value should be minus 0.5, because I want a negative shade also and a positive shade also. Let me click on apply and let me click on okay, right? So you can see the color are somewhat darker blue or somewhat darker orange or lighter blue, lighter orange according to the value. But this is the range which I gave, minus 0.5 till 0.4151. This has nothing to do with profit margin. Profit margin will be same. This is just to play with the colors, right? Now we have created the profit margin for every single state. There are a couple of options available over here. What are these options? Let us try to explore these options. Click on to this plus button and you will be zoomed in. Click out this minus button and you will be zoomed out. Let's suppose you are zoomed in so that you can see a situation for a particular map, but you want to go with a previous state, with the initial state. Then you just click on to this pin button. You just click on to this pin button and you will be in an initial state, right? Now you have one more button over here. Okay, what is that button? You have a adjustment button. Let's suppose you are creating a final dashboard, right? Let's suppose you are creating a final dashboard. You click over here in the final dashboard, and what you can do is you can just adjust the map in your dashboard wherever you want, right? This is to adjust the situation or the placement of the map, right? Now let's suppose you want to do analysis for some specific circles. You want to do analysis on some specific circles, right? So what you can do is you can just click onto this particular square box. Just a minute, guys. Pankaj, it's a live session. It's not a recording which is playing. All right. So what I wanted to give you that if you want to play with some specific dots, what you can do is you can just, select this square box and you can just select the circles and you will be able to do analysis onto that specific circle only. You hover your mouse cursor and you can see the data. United Kingdom, state is England, sales is this, and profit margin is this, right? Now you have one more option. You can do a selection on the basis of some circle like this. Only this circle will be selected. You can hover your mouse cursor over those circles and you can get the data that sales is this and profit margin is this, right? Now you have one more option available inside this pin, the freehand selection, the last option. If you want to select some specific circle, let's suppose I want to do analysis onto this area only. So what I'll do is I'll just select this circle freehand and only this circle will be highlighted and the other circles will be grayed out, right? And I can do my analysis like this way. So this is how you can calculate the profit margin for every single state, right? Now let me right click over here and let me rename the sheet. The sheet name will be profit margin and let me press enter. All right, let me create a rename the sheet as profit margin and let me just rename the sheet. Now let me create one more sheet because we have one more requirement from the business. What is the requirement? We have to create a scatter plot, customer wise scatter plot, and we have to calculate the sales and profit for every single customer. Now, how do I create that data visualization? I have the columns. Now I have to play with these options, right? I want to calculate the profit and sales for every single customer. This is the requirement which is coming from the business. For that, I can create a scatter plot. Now, what is a scatter plot? Let me show you that. Let me take the profit and let me put it into rows. I have sum of profit. Now, let me take sales, and let me put that sales into the column shelf. I have a single dot for profit and sales. Why is that? We have a single dot for profit and sales because the Tableau doesn't know on which dimension I have to calculate the data. So it is giving you all the calculation. It is calculating, or it is doing a sum for all the data, whichever is there, and it is giving you a final sum. All right, but we don't want a final sum. We have to specify a dimension, on which dimension we want to summarize our data. On which dimension we have to summarize our data. If you go to your dimension columns, you have a customer name. So on the basis of customer name, I want to summarize my data. All right. What I can do is I can take this customer name and I can put it into this detail. Now, why this detail box? Because I have to specify this dimension. The Tableau will go to my Excel sheet. It will see, okay, for every single customer, this is the sum. So I have to specify the dimension. To specify the dimension, I have to use this detail box, because I'm giving some detail to the Tableau that this is my dimension, and on this dimension I want to calculate my data, right? So let me get that customer name and let me put it into detail box, and you can see there are a lot of dots available into my scatter plot. There are some positive dots and there are some negative dots. All right, now this is the dot related to each and every single customer. This dots represents the each and every single customer, right? So yes, this dot represents the each and every single customer. Now what we have to do is I need to go to the shape and let me make it as solid shapes. All right, and let me go to this particular color box and let me improve the transparency, because those are the dots which are overlapping each other. If I improve the transparency, so I will be able to see those dots which are overlapping, which are overlapped. Let me just give the opacity as 75%. What is that opacity? Opacity is nothing but a transparency, right? Now I can see some of the transparency. If I hover my mouse cursor onto this particular customer, the customer name is Angie, the profit is 4,932 and the sales is 16,000, which is quite good. Now let me go to some of these customers. The customer name is Isa, the profit is 1836 and the sales is 11,271. That is also quite a good. Now let me go to some negative customers, the negative sales provided or the negative profitable customer. If I hover my mouse cursor over here, the customer name is Andrew and the profit is -287. That means this customer is giving us loss, and the sales we have done is 10,000. It is not mandatory that you have done a sales with this customer so you will be getting a profit. Sometimes you do a sales in a loss as well, right? Now let me hover my mouse cursor onto this customer. This is the customer which has given us the maximum loss. That is -3,957, and the name of the customer is Melody, and the sales is 5,653. Okay, so this Melody is really harmful for our company. All right, in that way we have to specify the things. Now, what else we can do? We have put the customer name into detail. Now we have a profit margin with us. If I want to calculate a profit margin as well, we have a profit margin also. Now what I can do is I can take this profit margin and I can put it into color box. I can give the shades. Since I have put it into the color box, this color legend has been created and it is giving me some information that blue dots are positive customer, positive profit providable customer, and these orange dots are the negative profitable customer. These are the customer who are giving us a loss. Again, if I want to play with the color, or again if I want to play with the color shade, then what I need to do is I just need to click onto this arrow button. I just need to click onto this edit color. I just need to click onto this advanced button, and let me click on this start, and let me give it a value as -0.5. This has nothing to do with profit margin. Profit margin will be calculated separately. Here I am just playing with the color shades, and end is 0.5. Let me click on apply and let me click on OK. The more the losses, the more the dark the color is, and the more the profit is, the more the color is, right? The more the color, the dark is. So this is how we can calculate the sales and profit for every single customer, right? If I hover my mouse cursor onto any particular customer, the name of the customer is Lara, profit is 2658, the sales is 6732, and the profit margin is positive 0.395, which is quite good. But this orange customer, these are the problematic customers. David, profit is minus 1840, sales is 2567, and the profit margin is minus 0.717, which is very, very much problematic, right? Now, yesterday we have learned the concept of global filter. Today also we have to apply the same concept of global filter over here. How from single dot it became so many? Because I have specified the dimension, the customer name. Previously, Tableau doesn't have any idea. This is the magic of dimensions and measures. Previously, Tableau doesn't have any idea. On which basis I have to calculate the data, on which ground I have to calculate my data, on which dimension I have to calculate my data. Now you have given a dimension to Tableau, that is your customer name. I have put that customer name into the detail box. I have given a detail, and now Tableau is calculating the sum, right? Tableau is calculating the data on the basis of each and every customer, the profit and the sales, the sum of profit and the sum of sales for each and every customer, right? This is how so many dots have been created. Okay, this is known as granularity. Now, what is a granularity? How granularity works? What is the relationship between granularity and the aggregation? These are the advanced topic which we will be covering into the advanced course. But right now, for your understanding purpose, if you want to calculate the data, if you want to calculate the measure on the basis of some ground, on the basis of some dimension, get that dimension into the detail box and your measures will be aggregated accordingly. All right. Now we have to apply a global filter over here. So in the profit margin sheet, we have already applied a filter on the basis of year. Let me click over here, and again let me go to the apply to worksheet option, and let me click on all using this data source. Let me repeat that point. If I want to apply a global filter, click over here, click on apply to worksheets, and click on this particular option called all using this data source. A global filter has been created. Now, what is that global filter? the global filter is, if I have 20-40 sheets, that means that global filter will be applicable to each and every sheet. Now I have only two sheets, so this particular global filter will be applicable to this sheet also. The name it says that global. Global means what? It will be applied globally, right? Now let me go to the second sheet. Can you see that year order date filter? Now let me click over here and let me click on show filter, so that you will be able to see this quick filter, right? Now let me click over here and let me click on to this particular option called single value list. I can see the single value list. Now I have this filter over here also, and I have this filter over here also. What is that global filter? If you have 30-40 sheets, will you go to each and every sheet and will you apply a sheet one by one? Will you apply the filter one by one? Don't you think that that will be a tedious task? And here I've applied a global filter that will be applicable to each and every sheet. And the magic of the global filter is, if I check 2011 over here, here also you will be getting the data for 2011. And here, if I check 2014, in the second sheet also, I will be getting the data for 2014. So it is getting reflected to each and every sheet. This is the magic of global filter. I wanted to do an analysis of the data for 2012. Here also, I have a data for 2012. And here also, I have a data for 2012. Let me rename the sheet. Right click over here and click on rename. What should be the name of the sheet? Customer wise profit or customer profit? All right. Now, finally, what we have to do? Finally, we have to create a beautiful dashboard so that the management people can play around with that dashboard and you will be promoted. All right. Let me click on to that dashboard. This is the button to create a dashboard. This is the button. If you want to create a dashboard, can you see that arrow? Now, this is the user interface to create a dashboard. Now, what I can do is I can just click over here and click on fixed size. And here, let me take this size as generic desktop. Generic desktop. I have this particular area, right? I have this particular area. Now what I can do is I can take this profit margin over here. What is the definition of a dashboard in Tableau? The definition of dashboard says that it's a collection of worksheets. It's a collection of worksheets. Now I have two worksheets with me. I can drag and drop both the worksheet into my dashboard and I can create a magic, right? First worksheet I have drag and drop over here. Now I have one more worksheet called customer profit. Let me drag and drop this customer profit, and it is asking me where to put. Here I will be putting over here, right? Now I can adjust the sheets as well. I can adjust the size of the sheet as well. Now I have the state-wise profit margin also. Can you see that? And I have the individual customer also. And I have the profit also. Profit and I have the sales and profit also. And I have the profit margin also for every single customer. But I have a specific requirement. I have a specific requirement that if I click onto any particular state, if I want to click onto any particular state, I can only be able to see the customer related to that particular state. I should not be able to see any other customer. I want to filter out my customer. How do I do that? How do I achieve that task? If I click onto this particular circle, this circle belongs to England state. So I will only be able to see the audience for England only. Can I achieve that task? Let me click over here. Nothing is happening. That means I have to create an action filter so that if I click over here, I can only see the customer related to England only. If I click over here into this particular state, that North Rihanna, I will only be able to see the customer related to North Rihanna. How do I achieve that task? To achieve that task, go to that particular sheet and click onto this filter button. Click onto this sheet and click onto this particular filter button. Can you see that filter button? Just click over here. Now my work is done. My action filter will be created. If I perform some action, clicking is an action, right? If I perform that action, some filtering will be done on the basis of customers, right? Let me click over here. Can you see? Other customers are gone, and I can only see those customers who are related to England only. Now let me hover my mouse cursor. The customer name is Harrison. The profit is 2,461. The sales is 5,725, and the profit margin is 0.30, which is quite good. Now let me go to this orange dot. The customer name is Rory, and the profit is -848. The sales is 1,266, and the profit margin is -0.670. Right? Now, how do I create a storyline from this particular dashboard? How can I create a storyline? You can also create a storyline also. Every data has a story. You have to get that story from the data. Every data has a story. Now, how do I create a storyline? Before creating the storyline, okay, let me just show you that if you want to get the data, or if you want to get the recording for today's session as well, go to this particular link, click over here, and this is where your all the recording will be available, right? You can click on to this link and get the recording, and like our Facebook page and follow our Facebook page so that you will be getting the notification for all the recording. And if you want to enroll for the 20 module course, you can enroll for the complete 20 module course. The batch is going to start from 30th of August, just in this Sunday. So hurry up, otherwise the prices will be high. We are providing this course at a very minimum cost called 3,540. And if you want to download the course content, all the 20 module, you can download the course content. And if you want to enroll, you can enroll. And if you have any other doubt, you can contact to this particular number. This is the number for our representative. His name is Kumar. You can contact to that number and all of your query will be answered related to the advanced course on Tableau. All right. Now I wanted to create a storyline from it, right? So to create a storyline, what I can do is I can just click on to this particular button. New story. Click over here and this particular story will be created, right? Now what I can do is I can drag and drop this particular dashboard over here. All right. Or before drag and drop my dashboard over here, what I can do is I can click over here and I can adjust the sizes automatic. So it will be adjusted automatically according to the size. If I click onto the storyline, the story, and let me drag and drop this dashboard. Okay. All right. It has been adjusted automatically according to the size only. Right. Now, if I want to, you know, do an analysis, I can just scroll my mouse cursor like this and click over here. My customer will be, highlighted on the basis of those things. This is the first story of my data. I can create a duplicate sheet also. Okay. I can create a duplicate sheet. Now, what is a storyline? The way you do your presentation in PPT for each and every angle, in the similar way, you can just show this particular storyline, or you can just show this particular data visualization one by one as a single stories to your management people. Kind of presentation, the way you do your PPT presentation. So let me create one more slide, you can say. So for that, I need to click onto this duplicate button. Can you see this duplicate button? Let me click onto this duplicate button and one more sheet will be created. Now in my previous sheet, in my previous story, I have shown the data for United Kingdom and England. Now this time I want to show the data for Germany. So go to your second sheet, second story, and click on to this Germany. So Germany's customer will be highlighted, right? And in the caption itself, we can write over here that data for England, data for England, right? And in the second caption here, you can write that data for Germany. So while presentation also, you will be having an idea that yes, this is the data for Germany. This is the customer for Germany. This is the profit margin for Germany. And this is the slide for Germany. This is the slide for England. And this is the customers for England. And if you want to scroll, you can scroll by this arrow button. Now, whatever sheets you want to create, whatever story you want to create for whichever country, you can create multiple 5 to 10 slides or 5 to 10 story, and you can represent your story on the basis of your data. And again, if you want to give a beautiful name to that dashboard, how do you give a beautiful name to that dashboard? Just let me click on to this button and let me click on to this option. Show dashboard title. Arjun, you can go on mute, please. Okay, if I wanted to give a beautiful title to that dashboard, how do I do that? Can you see this option in the object section? I have an option called show dashboard title. So let me click over here. And here I can give a dashboard. Here I can give the name of the dashboard. Let me remove this and let me just write over here that customer wise profit or profit margin or profit for states, whatever name you want to give. Like, let me write as profit and margin. Let me select that complete name. Let me click onto this Tableau board. Let me increase the size as 24. Let me make it in center and let me give it a color as a red. Click on apply, click on OK. And I don't like this name, profit margin. I can hide this title. Here I can, I don't like this name. It is taking a lot of space. Customer profit, let me hide this title. All right. So this is the name of the complete overall dashboard, right? So go to here. You can see the name of the complete dashboard and your story as well. All right. Now someone can ask me that if I want to give a proper background color of this name of the dashboard, then how do I do that? And I want this blue shade only. I want this perfect blue shade. I want this perfect blue shade in the background. Then how do I do that? What you can do is you can go over here. You can go to this color. I can go to this customer profit sheet. I can go to this customer profit sheet, which was my second sheet. I can go to the color. I can edit the color. Okay, I can click on to this particular button. I can click on to this square button. Let me repeat that point. Go to the color box, click on edit color, go to this square box and copy this HTML code. Can you see this HTML code? This is the color code. Let me copy that color code, click on OK, go to my story or go to my dashboard first of all. And here in the dashboard itself, you have an option called layout. All right. Now click on to this layout and go to this, select this one and go to this option called background. Okay. You have an option here called background. Go to this background, click on more color and here paste your HTML code and click on OK. Now that particular blue shade has been given. Now this particular profit margin is not looking good. So what I can do is I can double click over here, select everything and I can give it as a white color and click on apply. Now click on OK. Now it is looking good. Now go to your storyline and see this. Yes, it is reflecting over here as well. So this is the profit line. This is the story for the England. You can see this is the data for England. This is the customers for England. And this is the second sheet or second slide for the Germany's data, and these are the customer for Germany. Can you observe one thing about Germany's customer? You don't have even a single customer as a negative profit. Every customer is providing us a positive profit. All right, all the blue dots, that means the business in Germany is going really well, really well. But if I click onto this orange dot, this is giving me somewhat pain, which business people doesn't like. The profit margin is -0.223, which is also not good. Right. So this is how you can play your data. This is how you can create your dashboard. This is how you can make a story out of your dashboard, because each and every data has a story to tell. Now you have to get the story from the data and you have to prepare your data visualization. And this Tableau is now not an additional skill. This is a mandatory skill nowadays, because each and every management people needs a data visualization to take their business decisions. that time has gone where people used to analyze the data on the Excel sheet or on the database. Nowadays, each and every people is running behind the data visualization because it is very easy for them to take their business decisions. Let's suppose some COVID situation is going on. Not suppose, COVID situation is going on in India. Now, how government of India or how any state government will take the decision? They will see the data visualization. Okay, in this particular state, the situation for COVID is really bad. Lot of number of male people are affected, lot of number of female people are affected, lot of number of colonies are affected, lot of number of cities are affected, which city is more affected, which city is less affected. So on the basis of that data visualization, they can take their decisions. Every decision has to be backed by a data. Every decision has to be backed by a data visualization. You cannot take a decision in the air. The way your MS Office is a mandatory skill nowadays, and in the similar way, this particular Tableau is a mandatory skill nowadays, right? And it's a good to have skill in your resume since people are struggling with their job. This is the right time to upskill yourself in this lockdown period, right? So if you want to enroll for the complete advanced course, you can enroll and you can upskill yourself, improve your knowledge and update your skills. All right. If you have any doubt, any query, you can ask me. I'll be answering your questions. How story is different than the dashboard? Of course, in the story, you can go one by one, slide by slide. And in the dashboard, you have a complete data. This is the answer to your question, Megha. All right. So yes, that's it from my end. I hope you found this session very much informative. And you found this session very much, you know, some knowledgeable. I hope you learned something. So that's it from my end. In this situation, the COVID situation, you can be safe. Take care of yourself. Take care of your family members. And till then, this is Pawan signing off. And till then, happy learning, guys. Yes, Sanjeev, the Tableau advanced course, which are going to start on 30th of August, this is a chargeable course. We are going to start a full-time batch for the complete 20-module course, and the duration is 24 hours. So yes, that is chargeable, which is going to start from 30th of August. If you have any doubt, any query, you can contact this number. This is the number for our representative. If you want to learn the complete Tableau from A to Z, this is the number. All right. Thank you so much, guys. You have been an amazing audience. Thank you so much. You're talking about the application. The Tableau desktop is a paid version, but as far as Tableau public is concerned, Tableau public is a free version. You can download Tableau public and you can explore the options. But yeah, there are yes, options are also available as far as the Tableau public is concerned. Tableau public is a free tool and Tableau desktop is a paid version. So yes, you have almost each and every feature in Tableau public as well. For your learning purpose, Tableau public is more than enough. All right. Thank you so much, guys. Yes, we do have a connectivity for cloud, but if you want to connect with the cloud, you need a Tableau desktop. On Tableau public, there is a restriction for the connectivity to your databases. Thank you so much, guys. Yes, to generate the reports only. Yes, Suresh.